Hi, my name is Steve Porter. I'm a professional Scrum.org trainer. And I want to talk to you a little bit today about something that's really near and dear to my heart. It's this idea around technical debt and a term that I'm going to be calling not done work. And I'll explain what that means in a second. Technical debt is fairly well understood. It's decisions, sometimes conscious, sometimes there may be unconscious decisions that teams make where they're doing work that isn't at the quality level they would like. A good example for me, a team I work with, we had an application where we decided to hard code some information into a config file instead of building it into the app and making it easier to maintain. It allowed us to get something to production sooner, but we knew it was an area that it wasn't done as well as we would like it to do, and it might cost us some effort in the future to go fix it in future sprints. So here we had sprint one, have a piece of work going in. We have this little corner that we cut, it's a little bit of quick and dirty. That information did go back into our product backlogs. Basically, eventually go fix that hard code, right? So we'll get that piece done. Next sprint, you may find teams taking on other pieces of technical debt. I always encourage them to put it into the product backlog to make it transparent that here's work that we may or may not have to go back and fix. And in the case with my team, eventually we did go and address that issue. The challenge with technical debt is sometimes paying it back is a bit of an unknown. We think we know how much it's going to cost to do that work. It's an estimate, it's a forecast. Those obviously change. And with this config file change, as the application got bigger and bigger and we were drawing on that little bit of low quality work, the cost to pay it back was much harder than if we'd just done it right in the first place. However, the team made that conscious decision. I'm talking about team, product owner, development team made that conscious decision, and it allowed us to get items into production sooner. If we'd have had to do that work originally, it would have delayed the realization of value here. And that's a fair decision that teams make around, do we want to get value today or do we want to delay it and get value tomorrow? So that's how I look at technical debt. You're still able to put things into production, but we've cut some corners. It's a little bit of quick and dirty. And I always say with the quick and the dirty, the quick you get today, the dirty you have to live with forever. So that's technical debt. I want to compare that to this idea of not done work. That's something that a team will do. They'll make a decision to say, okay, here's what we can deliver. Before this can go into production, here's this other work that we need to do. However, that work we can't fit inside the sprint. The example I will often use is, in your organization, if you're using some open source code or maybe a third-party tooling, you need to run that license by the legal department before it can go into production. Teams can't do that every single sprint. I do appreciate that. So they will take that little bit of work, reviewing it with legal, maybe their security audits. You know all these different things that can happen that will stop you from going to production, and they'll put that into the product backlog, which is good. It makes it transparent. Everybody understands. This needs to be done before we can go into production. And depending on the organization, you can have sprint after sprint after sprint after sprint that you're building on, unable to go into production because this little piece of work, this work that stopped you from being done, is sitting in the product backlog. And eventually that work has to be done before you can go and put it into production. And again, estimating that work can be a bit of a challenge. Sometimes that work that you thought was this tiny bit is actually much larger. Again, forecasting is hard. Here's the insidious thing about not done work compared to technical debt that I always want to highlight with my teams. In the case of technical debt, I had some work that I needed to do later, but I had something in production. I'm getting some value from it. Getting some value from it, getting some value from it, getting some value from it. Here, I then have to pay back that debt. But I've been getting value all the way along. With not done work, not getting any value from this. It's not in production yet. Not getting any value. Not getting any value. Not getting any value. Okay, now we're going to go do that work. Awesome. We find out that that little piece of work that we thought we had to do, reviewing a license with legal, suddenly that surprises us with something. Maybe we find out that that piece of code that we wrote in sprint one isn't compliant. So not only do I have to fix it here, but I could potentially invalidate all of the work I had here, all of the work I had here, and all of the work I had here. With technical debt, you get an early realization in value. With undone work, not only are you putting future sprints in jeopardy, but you're putting every past sprint in jeopardy as well. So when the teams I'm working with, I do want them to appreciate the difference between technical debt and not done work, because sometimes team will pass off the, well, we've got some bugs in the system, that's just technical debt. It's like, no, if it's stopping you from going to production, that's actually not done work. And then I want to remind people the risk they're taking with all of the work they've done up until the time of getting in production because of that not done work that sticks around. So, professional development teams, you may take on technical debt. That might be something you do. Do not take on not done work. It's just too much risk.